dancing house of So You Think You Can Dance, a personal fan of yours.
Thank you very much.
This person first time interviewed me in 2010 in New York. I've been interviewed by you. Now we're switching. So, on So You Think You Can Dance, right? Being a host for so many seasons, you know, we know that certain things can go wrong. Is anything ever happened to you there?
Well, yes, of course, there's always a couple. I'll tell you, maybe I'll get to two.
Okay.
But one was I was adding a little bit of an addition right here, and they were sick on. And so when I was talking to a contestant, all of a sudden, the right one, I started to feel it peel off while I was actually talking to the contestant. It was like peeling off. And right when I finished talking to him, it dropped to my waist, and it went to the third judge. And then right away, I said to Nigel, I said, we went into commercial break. I said, turn the lights out. Turn all the lights out.
He goes,
what is wrong with you? I said, what's wrong with me? I said, look, my boob is down at my waist. You know, they turned the lights off. I went running off the set. I tore both of those things out. I never wore anything like that again, I have to say. And that was like...
Okay, embarrassing question.
Embarrassing thing.
So... have it been seen on camera, like literally that is...
Well, I don't know that anybody at home noticed, but let me tell you, when you feel something peeling off your body, when you are engaged on live TV, you know what's happening. It really drives you nuts, and I freaked out. Oh my God. Another thing that happened was someone from Florida was a good friend of mine, the Gold and Diamond Source in Tampa, Florida.
Yeah.
She had lent me $1.5 million worth of diamonds for the finale.
A million and a half
worth of diamonds. And so on the day of the finale, they were supposed to arrive to me in my dressing room, and I have to sign for them and everything. And so she calls me, and she said, I got the message. They're delivered. Do you have the diamonds in your hands? And I said, no, I don't have the diamonds. My whole body just shut down. And she said, well, you need to go out of your dressing room right now and find those diamonds. So I went out. I had a volcano mask on my face. I'm running through the hallways. And there's another show, by the way. There's always two shows that film. And I think it was Rockstar at the time with Tommy Lee and all these people. I'm running through. All you see is my two white eyes and my mouth. And I'm running up to security. Has anybody taken a package? Run up to the front desk of CBS because we actually were a Fox show, but we film at CBS. Nobody had them. I went to the So You Think You Can Dance office. Nobody had them. I'm calling her, I said, we don't have them. She said, they have been delivered. You must find them. What happened is they went to the general mail office, and they had them. They had it, but they were never even going to tell me. They was just laying in a massive stack of packages and letters. And finally, they got the diamonds to me just in time for when
you
we were
going
You never
know air. What your post office is carrying, right?
Oh, no, you don't. And you never know, because a lot of times they're, you know, I hate to say it, but stuff like that is, you know, flying around.
Absolutely.
And I was going to have a heart attack because, you know, when you're entrusted with something like that, you want to take good care. And that was so upsetting to me. Like, I was so flustered before the live show.
Thank you. I love your stories. We can talk all day, but you have to come back to the live broadcast soon. Ladies and gentlemen, tune in to watch Amazing Mary.
So you see, you can dance at 8, 7, and Central. That's right.
Yes, plus you're here on Motion Capture Dance, leading live broadcast as well. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching. Enjoy Millennium Dancesport Championships.